I think I was in class 6th or 7th when my classmates were watching Power Ranger SVT. I was hearing Marishwas at the same time. So John Elia, the famous Shire, he said that घर से घर तलक गए होंगे, अपने ही आप तलक गए होंगे, आज जो है मैं आदमी जाम होंगे छलक गए होंगे। भैया 80 सीट होती है IAS बनने के लिए, आप कैसे कह दे रहे हो कि आपका दिल टूटेगा तो आप UPSC कर लोगे। I cleared JEE Advanced twice. So it's my misfortune that I am in NIT Jalandhar. No, on TikTok the poetry that you see on open mics and social houses, they have just like मैं उठा नहाया खाया चलाया मैंने साबुन लगाया लाइफ बॉय, तो ये थी मेरी कविता लाइफ बॉय, तो ये पोएट्री नहीं है।
यार जनरली कॉलेज में लोग आते हैं तो लाइक किसी को सिंगर बनना होता है, किसी को एक्टिंग में जाना होता है, किसी को अपना पैशन फॉलो करना होता है, किसी को गिटार पे जाना बहुत अच्छा लगता है, बट इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट कि कोई बंदा अपना पैशन फॉलो कर पाए एंड उस चीज को एक्चुअली अपना करियर ऑप्शन बना ले जो कि वो करना चाहता है। तो इस वीडियो में हम बात करने वाले हैं एक ऐसे ही इंसान की जो कि अभी ही इज करंटली स्टडिंग इन हिज थर्ड ईयर एट NIT जलंधर एंड ही हैज लाइक अचीव्ड अ लॉट इन हिज लाइफ। लाइक ही इज पॉपुलरली नोन एज इंजीनियर ऑफ पोएट्री एंड उन्होंने काफी कुछ पोएट्री में अचीव किया है, काफी सारे कॉलेजेस में उन्होंने शोज किए हैं। बेसिकली ही इज स्टैंड अप कॉमेडी टाइप पोएट एंड उन्होंने लाइक काफी सारी पोएट्रीज लिखी है, उनकी एक बुक भी पब्लिश हो चुकी है। तो इस वीडियो में हम बेसिकली डिस्कस करने वाले हैं उनसे कि लाइक देयर इज ऑलवेज अ कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन बिटवीन पैशन एंड अ करियर, तो कैसे उन्होंने ये अपनी डिफिकल्टी चॉइस को आगे रखा एंड ही फॉलोड हिज पैशन। तो एंड काफी सारी मोटिवेशन भी मिलने वाली है इफ यू आर लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड कि हाँ यार मुझे भी ये चीज करनी है। तो इन दिस वीडियो आई हैव विद मी संदीप शुक्ला, ही इज करंटली अ थर्ड ईयर अंडरग्रेजुएट एट NIT जलंधर एंड वी हैड अ रियली अमेजिंग इंटरेक्शन रिगार्डिंग हिज करियर, रिगार्डिंग हिज एडवाइस फॉर दोज हु लाइक आर नॉट एबल टू फुलफिल देयर पैशन एंड मतलब काफी फन एंड काफी इंटरेस्टिंग इंटरेक्शन होने वाली है। तो बिफोर वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम लेट्स जस्ट मूव ऑन टू दिस पर्टिकुलर इंटरेक्शन। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद टुडेज अमेजिंग वीडियो लेट्स हैव संदीप शुक्ला से समथिंग अबाउट हिम।
Hello, this is Sandeep Shukla. As Arsh have introduced myself earlier, but something just I want to tell from my side also. My name is Sandeep Shukla and I am stand-up comedian and poet. And currently I am pursuing my undergraduate from NIT Jalandhar. I have done my schooling from MPVM Gangavaram. That's all, I think.
When you talk about you as a person, like... So the thing is like poetry is considered to be a trade or it's a kind of thing that generally people don't, it's not a normal thing that people prefer. Like generally what the Indian parents' perspective is like whether their child should be a doctor, whether their child engineer, whether their child should be something related to maybe he's pursuing a CA. But the field poetry is something like that is not very common in Indian culture. So how did you start with this poetry? Like what was the first stance, how you get a chance? So would like to more know more about like from where did you start this poetry?
Yeah, poetry is just a non-conventional thing when you talk about it as a profession, but something that you know that when you belong to a traditional Indian upper class family, then you have to just go through the flow and you have to be in mainstream regarding that. You have to just focus on whether you should go in medical field or you should go in engineering. But in my case, I got very much support from my family, and it and when someone asked me about what from there I started poetry and how I got into it, I think the most suitable answer that I can give is when I was in class 6th or 7th when my classmates were watching Power Ranger SVT, I was hearing Marishwas at the same time. So there's a saying in Hindi, bhoot ke paon palne mein dikhlate, the same goes with me. And you know, but to choose it as a profession, I have to do a lot for it. Quoting Abraham Lincoln, he once said that if you give me 5 minutes to cut down a tree, I will take 3 minutes to sharpen the axe. So I was sharpening my axe till class 12, and after that I came into the poetry from my first year, as you know.
दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉमन सेइंग कि वेदर पोएट्री इज एन इनेट क्वालिटी और समबडी कैन राइट कोट्स और समबडी कैन लर्न टू लाइक राइट पोएट्री. सो व्हाट इज योर पर्सपेक्टिव ऑन दिस, लाइक इज इट समथिंग इनबॉर्न टैलेंट
पोएट्री
और इन पर्सन कैन लर्न हाउ टू राइट थिंग्स?
Yeah, in the words of Wordsworth, that poetry is basically flow of emotion. And John Elia, the famous shayar, he said that ghar se ghar talak gaye honge, apne hi aap talak gaye honge, aaj jo hai main aadmi, jaam honge, chalak gaye honge. And Gopal Das Neeraj, the famous saying of Gopal Das Neeraj is, आत्मा के सौंदर्य का शब्द रूप है काव्य, मानव होना भाग्य है कभी होना सौभाग्य. सो यू सी देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग्स रिगार्डिंग द सेम, देयर आर प्लेथरा ऑफ थिंग्स रिगार्डिंग द सेम प्रोफेशन एंड यू मस्ट, एंड इन माय पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू द माय ओपिनियन इज दैट यू हैव समथिंग व्हेन यू राइट एंड यू कैन, यू ऑलवेज कैन शार्पन योर स्किल, बट यू हैव समथिंग व्हेन यू राइट. So I will not tell that please don't do hard work for it and anything. Yeah, you sharpen your qualities, you sharpen your skills when you do hard work, but it is something just I believe that it is inborn.
So just asking out of curiosity, like it is a common saying that a person after he has a heartbreak in his love life, so he turns into a shayar. So what is the difference between that shayar who has got his heart broken and the shayar who is in general pursuing it as a passion? Matlab in Hindi, if I would like to contemplate it, ki dil toote aashiq bhi shayar ban jate hain and normal shayar mein kya difference hai?
Nahin, ye to matlab ye wahi hai na, ye to it's just like rubbish saying that you say, see na, that abhi jaise chal raha hai ye ki मतलब दिल नहीं टूटा तो यूपीएससी कर लेंगे, मतलब दिल टूट गया तो ये यूपीएससी में हो जाएगा. अरे भैया 80 सीट होती है आईएएस बनने के लिए, आप कैसे कह दे रहे हो कि आपका दिल टूटेगा तो आप यूपीएससी कर लोगे? मतलब कुछ भी चल रहा है मार्केट में और इसको लोग बड़े लेवल पे प्रमोट कर रहे हैं, तो ये निकम्मों की एक सेइंग है कि दिल टूटे लोग शायर बन जाते हैं. जो लोगों ने मतलब इकबाल अशर का एक शेर है कि ठहरी ठहरी सी तबीयत पे रवानी आई, ढल गई उम्र, ठहरी ठहरी सी तबीयत पे रवानी आई और आज हमको ये बात याद पुरानी आई, इतनी आसानी से नहीं मिलती फन्ना ए दौलत, ढल गई उम्र तो गजलों पे जवानी आई. सो व्हेन समवन सेज दैट दिल टूट गया तो अब तू शायर बन जाएगा, तो इतना आसान नहीं होता भैया.
स्टार्टेड विद योर इंजीनियरिंग करियर, लाइक यू परस्यूड इंजीनियरिंग, सो व्हेन डिड दिस थॉट ऑफ गोइंग टू बी एन इंजीनियर केम एंड लाइक व्हाट वाज द सपोर्ट फ्रॉम फैमिली एंड फ्रेंड्स? सो वी वुड लाइक टू नो मोर अबाउट दिस जर्नी ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, हाउ यू कंटिन्यू.
Yeah, when you see that in Northern India, we have a trend, E stands for engineering. If you are doing well in your academics till class 10th or 12th, so E stands for engineering. So it was sort of challenge for me rather than it was not my interest. I cleared JEE Advanced twice. So it's my misfortune that I am in NIT Jalandhar. No, I would not say it's my misfortune, but it's, and it, yeah, it would not be an exaggeration to say that 70% of credit of my success goes to my parents and my family. So I would say that it's something that when you achieve a milestone, it's a huge support from your family and your surroundings.
So we have seen that you have been a guest at various events at these colleges, be it Thapar University or any other university throughout India. You have been going to places, interacting with people, going on stage, like facing audience in thousands. So like you also was a guest in your own college. So how is that feeling actually?
Yeah, I have been guest in, I think 11 IITs and 9 IITs and a couple of IIMs, but you know,
great.
It all started back in 2018 when I appeared for JEE Advanced and I could not make into the IITs. My friends used to tease me as Sandeep NIT matlab non IIT hota hai. And after 6 months I was guest in their college. So it was a bit a bumpy ride for me, but it was quite exploring as well.
It is not just about poetry, like you have been doing a bit of
laughter comedy, that is something called as stand-up comedy. So along with that, you are maintaining your studies as well. So like, how do you get time and how do you manage things according to you?
Yeah, I think how you manage your priority is the utmost thing required at that moment. I've heard a quote that the key is not to prioritize your what's on your schedule. The key is to schedule your priorities. Now, so you must schedule your priorities. And at the same time, if you do wrong, if you means, अगर आप थोड़ा सा भी फिसलते हैं ना, तो वो चीजें होती है ना, जिस कॉपी में बहुत सारे सब्जेक्ट का काम होता है वो रफ बन जाती है. सेम हैपेंस व्हेन यू डू अ मींस इफ यू डू लिटिल बिट mismanagement, then this your life would be a rough copy.
That's like awesome. So next is like, people generally have this thing like, should they go ahead with their passion? Like, will that, like, will they be successful bread earner for their family if they'll pursue their passion? Like, there are many people who are talented singers, who are talented, like, they want to pursue cricket, they want to pursue any other field apart from their own studies. But there are times that they have to think it twice. So like, for those people like who are currently maybe in their first year, second year, third year, and they have these talents and they want to pursue them as a career, so what advice you would like to give to them?
Yeah, there would be demotivation, there would be always there, the old days are not same. So I would like to suggest them, if you ever feel demotivated or any kind of disappointment you have, just think of the question that why have you started. This question in your mind, when it occurs, it dominates thousands of confusion regarding your career, and you start with the same fuel, same burning in yourself, and you go through your goal.
Great. So when we talk about Sandeep right now, so Sandeep is a stand-up comedian, he is a poet, he is also a budding engineer. So what if we give you a hypothetical situation, like, if not a poet, what would Sandeep Shukla be?
Yeah, if not poet, I would be mostly in the series of alphabet where E stands for engineering. There is also I stand for an IAS officer. So I might be getting into civil services or something else. And right now you have to deliver a question on the video. There are two types of IAS right now, one before aspirant and one after TBF aspirant. So I would be one that was one before aspirant.
Great. So like, let's move on to the concluding part of our interaction. So it was really very amazing interaction. Like, any advice that you like to give to somebody who wants to be good in his career of being a stand-up comedian or being in poetry? So what at last you would like to say to somebody who wishes to pursue this as a career?
Yeah, I would like to suggest them that please don't take shortcut. There would be hindrances, there would be hurdles, there would be challenges, and sometimes you will see that people who you see as your well-wisher will back with you, and all that stuff will go on. But I would suggest that you should keep on focusing on your goal and all that stuff. In poetry, when people come and they say, I got regular messages, sir, please check kar dijiye, ye poetry check kar lijiye, aur ye poetry. They don't have trained themselves. They don't have done homework with the poetry. They don't have trained in any manner, but they just wake up and write the poetry. So I have seen that the poetry that one you see on TikTok, the poetry that you see on open mics and social houses, they have just like, main utha nahaya khaya chala aaya maine sabun lagaya life boy to ye thi meri kavita life boy, to ye poetry nahi hai na. To poetry ke liye bhi aapko matlab ek lamba safar tay karna padta hai. To main ek wahi kahunga ki aap shortcut na le to zyada better.
That was an amazing interaction. Thank you so much, Sandeep, for taking out time and accepting this invitation. And would like to thank you once again for coming here and inspiring a lot of people who are currently in their first year, second year, or third year and wish to pursue this something different from the usual line. Thank you so much for coming here.
Thanks a lot.